What's going on, guys? The Trash Product here, bringing you a brand new video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you the best settings for OBS while recording. If you're here for streaming, this is going to be the wrong video to click on. This is for recording only. I don't stream. My internet isn't good enough to stream, so I don't really worry about that. The main point of this video is how to not drop frames when you're playing a PC game like Fortnite, or maybe you're playing Call of Duty on the PC, or God of War, something like that. And basically, just go into your settings first, go to video. This should be, your FPS should be at 60 all the time here, and that's what you're going to want to put your max FPS at in-game as well. A lot of people put it at like unlimited or 120 so they can get more FPS in-game. Just put your maximum at 60. You might have like one or two skips here and there. I haven't noticed anything, so I haven't noticed any skips in-game at all, but I don't know if this is going to be the same for you guys. You guys might have a different PC than I have, so you might have like a skip. I don't know. I haven't seen any difference in performance. So in game, put your max FPS to 60, and I promise you, you're not going to get any frame drops. I haven't. I've tested it out. I kept getting frame drops every 2 seconds, and I could not record my PC games. Well, I finally figured it out. Put your max at 60. But yeah, starting out, my OBS might be different looking than yours because I changed my theme to this top one here. So I don't know, I just thought it looked cool, so I changed it. General, nothing really there. You're not going to mess with stream. Next, the first thing is going to be output, so you're not going to want this on streaming. And actually, make sure you have your output mode to advanced. The default will be on simple. Change it to advanced. Go to recording. Type is standard. Don't mess with the custom output unless you know what you're doing. Your recording path is where you're going to be, or where the videos are going to be saved to. So just go to browse, find the folder that you want your videos to be saved to, and then you're done. You don't really have to mess with this. Recording format, MP4. If you know what you're doing, you can change it to something else. I have it on MP4 because that's just what almost every editing software deals with is MP4. Audio track 1, unless you know what you're doing, you can change these whatever you want, but I have mine at 1 all the time. Encoder, a lot of people have this at time 64, which is fine. I change it to the NVIDIA encoder because it's going to use the graphics card instead of the processor to encode the video. So if you don't have an NVIDIA graphics card or an AMD graphics card, just do time 64 and then it'll be fine. Your CPU usage might go up a little bit, so you might have to mess with some settings, which I'll go over in this video. But yeah, if you have a graphics card, change it to the whichever one it is, either NVIDIA or AMD. Don't rescale the output. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about custom muxer settings, whatever. Next thing, you come down to rate control. Use CBR, which is constant bitrate. The sweet spot for bitrate is going to be 40,000. This is, like I said, this is for recording. If you're streaming, this is going to look really high, but this is for recording, so it's going to be high. 40,000 is the sweet spot. If you have like a beast of a computer, you can up that to like 50 or 60,000. But yeah, this is going to be some pretty decent quality at 40,000. If you watch any of my PC videos, that's what it's going to be, or PC gameplay videos, this is what it's going to be at. If you don't have that good of a PC, you can lower it a little bit. I think at about 20,000 is when the quality starts to get a little, like, not as great. So I would say keep it above 20,000, keep it below 40,000 for sure. I might try and increase this a little bit because I haven't had any frame drops, but keyframe is 0, preset default, profile main, level auto. These are all the default settings, so you really don't have to worry about them. Use 2-pass encoding, and then everything else is the same. Next, going to audio. My sample rate is at 48,000, and I'm going to show you why. So I know that Windows 10 just had an update, so it might be a little bit difficult to navigate, but go down here to the bottom right, right-click on the speaker icon thing, go to sounds, go to recording, and then whatever your microphone, the microphone that you're using, just right click on it, go to properties, go to advanced, and this right here, whatever this number is, you want to change it to your sample rate in OBS. So mine is 48,000 Hz. Now just change it to the number. I know this is a little different, HE and KHC, but you want to change it to the number. So mine is 48,000. We're going to change it to that in OBS. So close out of that. channel stereo, everything's pretty much default. I have these as default because those are my default audio settings, being my Astro headset and my Astro microphone. So I just keep these at default, but you can select which ones you want, whatever you're using. I don't mess with these settings. Go to video. There's no real reason to change these to anything lesser than 1920 by 1080 unless your CPU absolutely cannot handle it. But in that case, you probably want to upgrade your CPU because these are just standard settings. You're going to notice it in your recording, so you want to have the best quality. Downscale filter changes to 32 samples. FPS is going to be at 60. Hotkeys, you can mess with that. My start and stop recording is at F10. You can change it to whatever you want. Advanced settings, process priority changes to above normal. Keep this at Direct 3D11. Color format, I have it at NV12. I think you can do RGB. I don't think it makes a difference, so don't worry about it. I should probably change this to 709. But I have it at 601 for now. I'm still testing out a couple of settings. This doesn't make a big difference. Maybe a tiny bit of quality increase, but not a lot, like 1%, 2% of increased quality. Not too big of a deal. You can change this to full. Right now, I have it at partial. Again, not a big quality increase, but I'll have to mess with these settings by myself. Audio, I just changed this to default because my default settings are already set. And then recording, this is going to be your file name. This isn't really a big deal. Oh, I actually didn't even notice this drop down, but yeah, that's actually going to be pretty much it. There's nothing really else to change. And I think that's going to be the whole video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If this works for you, if you guys really like this video, make sure you leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.